हेलो, टुडे वी विल सॉल्व वन गेट 2020 क्वेश्चन। द क्वेश्चन नंबर इज 20। अ फ्लाई व्हील इज अटैच्ड टू एन इंजन टू कीप इट्स रोटेशनल स्पीड बिटवीन 100 रेडियन पर सेकेंड एंड 110 रेडियन पर सेकेंड। इफ द एनर्जी ऑफ फ्लक्चुएशन इन द फ्लाई व्हील बिटवीन दीज टू स्पीड्स इज 1.05 किलो जूल, देन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द मूवमेंट ऑफ एनर्जी ऑफ द फ्लाई व्हील। To solve this question, one can refer to the NPTEL video lectures, which is mentioned over here. Let's start solving this question. So the turning moment diagram, which is shown in the right hand side, is the turning moment diagram of single cylinder double acting steam engine. This turning moment diagram is taken as an example to understand the working of the flywheel, that how the energy fluctuates and the speeds changes. So we can see from the turning moment diagram that the turning moment is represented along the y-axis and the crank angle is represented along the x-axis. It can be observed that during the outstroke O G O G E, the turning moment is maximum at G, which is at approximately the at theta equal to 90 degree. Also, for the instroke, the maximum value occurs at K, which is at theta equal to approximately at 270 degree. So, if we calculate the mean torque against which the engine works is given by the OE. This OE represent the mean torque, and this can be calculated as is area under O G P K Q divided by 2 pi. That means the area under the whole curve divided by 2 pi. 2 pi is the one complete rotation of the crank angle. Now, if we observe that when the crank moves from point A to point B, the total amount of work done by the engine is given by the area under A, F, G, H, P. This whole area represents the total amount of work done by the engine. So A to B, total work done by engine. A, F, G, H, B. Now, to overcome the resisting torque, the work is needed is only the area A, F, H, B. This area is needed to overcome the resisting torque. So, work done, work needed. Work needed is only the area AFHB. So there is an extra amount of work which is done by the engine, which is represented as FGH. So this is the excess work. FGH. Now this excess work increase the speed of the engine. And it is stored in the flywheel. in the form of kinetic energy. Now if we move after the B point, when the crank angle moves from B to C, so here the work needed for the external resistance is proportional to the area BHJC. So B to C, work needed is area BHJC. But if you observe, the amount of work done by the engine is only BHPJC. So this is the amount of work done by the engine. Work done by engine. So we observe that the work done by engine is less than the work needed. So the required amount of work, that is in the loss, is made up by the flywheel, which gives up the sum of its energy and speed decreases during this period. So we know that here at point B, the speed increased because of excess work. But after B, when it reaches the point C, it has consumed the work from the flywheel, the energy from the flywheel. So the speed of the flywheel at point C, the speed decreases. The consumption of energy from flywheel. So in this way the flywheel works as a energy reservoir, where the engine needs the more amount of energy than it does, so it takes from the flywheel. So coming to the question, we have been given that this fluctuation of energy as 1.05 kilojoule and the rotational speed as 100 radian per second and 110 radian per second. So we know that it is in the form of kinetic energy, rotational kinetic energy. So the delta E is half I omega max square minus half I omega minimum square. This moment of inertia is same because the flywheel doesn't change here. So when we take a common omega max square minus omega minimum square, so delta is given as 1.05 kilojoule, that is 10 to the power 3. I we have to calculate. Omega max is 110 and omega minimum is 100. So after solving this, we get I is equal to 1 kg meter square. So this is the answer.